In this video, we're going to discuss a kind of end behavior called slant asymptotes. So the directions here say to discuss the end behavior of this rational function, f of x equals 2x squared plus 5x minus 3, all over x plus 2. In a minute, I'll tell you what a slant asymptote is and how to find it. But first, let's just start by looking at what the limits are as this function goes to positive and negative infinity. That will be our starting point for thinking about the end behavior of this function. So let's try to remember how to find the limits at infinity of a rational function. We'll start with the limit at positive infinity. So I have the limit as x goes to infinity of 2x squared plus 5x minus 3 all over x plus 2. So if we start by thinking about what's happening to the numerator and denominator as x goes to infinity, what we're going to discover is both the numerator, right, this quadratic expression I have here, and the denominator, this linear expression, both of these, the top and bottom, are going to approach infinity as x goes to infinity. So then what I end up with is I end up with this form infinity over infinity, which we've said in the past means that we need to do more algebra of some sort to figure out the answer. This infinity over infinity is what we call an indeterminate form. Now, if you remember from a few videos ago, a method that's often very helpful when looking at the limit at infinity of a rational function is to divide both the numerator and the denominator by x to some power, where that power is the highest power in the denominator. So let me show you what I mean. For this function, the highest powered term in the denominator is x. Right? I have x to the first power here. So what I'm going to do to proceed is I'm going to rewrite this limit in kind of a strange way. I'm going to divide every term by x, every term in the numerator and denominator by x. So if I do that, I will get this expression. And then I'm going to reduce this wherever possible. So I end up with the limit as x goes to infinity of, in the numerator, 2x plus 5 minus 3 over x, and then in the denominator, 1 plus 2 over x. So now that I've rewritten my limit, let's try to think about the limit once again. And I'm going to think about this term by term. So first of all, let's think about these terms 3 over x and 2 over x. What's happening to these terms as x goes to infinity? Well, as x goes to infinity, both 3 over x and 2 over x are going to approach 0 because the denominator of those fractions is getting larger and larger and larger while the top stays constant. What about these constants 5 and 1? What's happening to those as x goes to infinity? Well, as x goes to infinity, these terms just stay constant. So as x goes to infinity, 5 goes to 5, and 1 goes to 1. Well, what about this term 2x? Well, as x goes to infinity, 2x is also going to get larger and larger and larger and approach infinity. So from this, I can see now what the overall value of this limit is. On the top here, the top is approaching infinity, and the bottom's just approaching some constant 1. So then my overall limit is infinity. Now let's also quickly look at the limit as x goes to negative infinity. Now luckily, I've already done a lot of the work here. I'm just going to go straight to my rewritten form. And now I can think about this in much the same way as I did in the limit as x goes to positive infinity. So as x goes to negative infinity, these terms 3 over x and 2 over x are once again going to approach 0. My constants are going to stay constants, so approaching 5 and approaching 1 for those terms respectively. And then this term 2 over x, as x goes to negative infinity, 2 over x is going to go to negative infinity. So then from that, I can see the overall value of this limit is negative infinity. So by this work here, I've determined a little bit of information about the end behavior of the function. I know that as x goes to positive infinity, my function values go to positive infinity, and as x goes to negative infinity, my function values go to negative infinity. But there's a little bit more information I can gather here. This function actually goes to infinity and negative infinity in a special way called a slant asymptote. So let me take a minute to give you a few facts about slant asymptotes. So first of all, slant asymptotes occur when the graph of a function f approaches a line, and specifically a line with finite non-zero slope, as x goes to plus or minus infinity. And here I've given you just a really quick sketch of what that could look like. So here my slant asymptote is in blue, and I have some function f, and we can see that on the ends of the graph, that is, as x goes to positive and as x goes to negative infinity, I see that the way my function behaves is to approach this line. So that's a definition of a slant asymptote, conceptually. So when do slant asymptotes happen? Slant asymptotes occur in rational functions when the degree of the numerator is 1 greater than the degree of the denominator. An example of that would be the function we're looking at in this example. So in our particular function here, we see that the degree of the numerator is 2, right? I've got this x squared as my highest power term on the top. The degree of the denominator is 1, right? So the degree of the numerator is 1 greater than the degree of the denominator. So we're going to have a slant asymptote in this case. So let me finish out this little discussion by giving you sort of the technical definition of a slant asymptote. So a line y equals L of x, and once again this is a line with finite non-zero slope, and all that means is that it's not a horizontal or vertical line. So this line that we're calling y equals L of x is a slant asymptote of our function f of x if the limit as x goes to infinity of f of x minus L of x equals 0, or the limit as x goes to negative infinity of f of x minus L of x equals 0. And all these limits are telling us is what we saw visually in my little example graph up here. Okay, so this is saying that this line L of x is a slant asymptote if, as x goes to infinity, the function f of x and the line L of x get closer and closer together, so that is the limit of their difference goes to 0 as x goes to infinity, or as x goes to negative infinity. So let's go back to our example. So now that we know what a slant asymptote is, let's talk about how we actually find that slant asymptote. The way we actually find the slant asymptote is by using a process called long division, which hopefully you remember from pre-calculus, but I'll show you the process here as well. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to take my rational function, and I'm going to actually do a long division of polynomials. So I'm going to take 2x squared plus 5x minus 3 and divide it by x plus 2. So to do this, I am going to start by looking at the leading terms both under this division sign and outside the division sign. And what I'm going to start by asking myself is how many times does x go into 2x squared? Or another way you can think about that is x times what equals 2x squared? So the answer to that question is 2x, right? 2x times x gives me 2x squared. So then I'm going to put that term up top here. Now my next step then, after I have that 2x, is to take my result and multiply it by this expression outside the division sign. Okay, so I'm going to multiply 2x by the quantity x plus 2. And that's going to give me 2x squared plus 4x. And I'm going to subtract that entire quantity. Okay, so if you do this correctly, these first terms should always cancel out, right? 2x squared minus 2x squared is 0, And then I have 5x minus 4x, which just gives me x. And I can bring down my minus 3. And now I'm going to repeat the same process. But now I'm going to be asking myself, how many times does x go into x? Well, the answer to that is 1. So now I get a plus 1 up top. And then I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to take this plus 1, the result I just got, and multiply it by the entire quantity x plus 2, which in this case is just going to, of course, give me x plus 2, and I subtract that entire quantity. Okay, so here x minus x is 0, negative 3 minus 2 gives me negative 5. So now I'm done because x will not go into negative 5. So negative 5 is actually what I will call my remainder. Now this expression up top, this 2x plus 1, is actually our slant asymptote, right? This is the equation of a line. But let me tell you in a little more detail why we know that that's a slant asymptote in this case. So what we've discovered in this process of long division is the following. My original rational function here, 2x squared plus 5x minus 3 all over x plus 2 is actually equivalent to 2x plus 1 minus a remainder of 5. And when I write my remainder, I write it over x plus 2. Okay, so these expressions are equivalent. And what I'm proposing is I'm proposing that our slant asymptote, which we'll call L of x, equals 2x plus 1. So remember that technical definition of the slant asymptote. So let's look at the limit as x goes to infinity of f of x minus L of x. But I'm going to use this version of f of x. So this equals the limit as x goes to infinity of f of x, which is 2x plus 1 minus 5 over x plus 2. Okay, and then minus L of x, my proposed slant asymptote, which is the quantity 2x plus 1. Okay, so I see here that my 2x plus 1's cancel, so I'm left with a limit as x goes to infinity of negative 5 over x plus 2, and we can see that that limit is going to equal 0, right? The denominator of that fraction is going to get larger and larger. And I could do, similarly, the limit as x goes to negative infinity, in which case I would also get 0. So this tells me that as x goes to plus or minus infinity, my function f of x gets arbitrarily close to this line L of x equals 2x plus 1. So I'll finish by quickly showing you a graph of this function and its slant asymptote. So here in black, I've graphed our rational function f of x that we've been looking at. And in pink, I've graphed its slant asymptote. And we see that indeed on the ends, as x goes to positive infinity and as x goes to negative infinity, I see that my function f of x gets closer and closer to this line. And if I were to zoom out, you would see that it got even closer to the line. So hopefully this gives you a good sense of what a slant asymptote is and how to find it using the process of long division.